Wat gaan we doen vandaag, Leon?
We gaan naar Parijs voor Splinter Cell Blacklist.
I'm Andy Wilson and I'm a producer working in Ubisoft Toronto and I'm responsible for the single player side of Splinter Cell Blacklist, which is our first title that we're releasing from the studio. We're here today actually showcasing some more of the game for the first time to the press, so we're showing two sort of final missions from Splinter Cell Blacklist's single player campaign, and what we're really trying to do is showcase just how much content we've built and the variety and the depth that exists within Blacklist. We are sending Sam all over the world in this game. The Blacklist is essentially a series of escalating attacks on US interests, initially around the world, but then actually coming onto US soil. What's happened is a group of rogue nations have sort of grouped together to sponsor a guy called Sadiq, who is Sam's arch nemesis in the game. And he's pulled together an organization of terrorists globally called the Engineers. And these are the guys who are quite literally engineering the Blacklist. And Sam, with his new team, which is a small group of elite people from various disciplines, has to come together and try and stop the Blacklist before it results in disaster for the US.
Sam, talk to me.
Your contact's been made, he's dead.
We got more militia en route. Advise you move out, sir.
All right, I need options. Now would be good.
The person next to me on the screen, this is Anna Groom's daughter. She's a character from classic Splinter Cell, obviously. Her and Sam have quite an antagonistic relationship. Sam, initially in the game, actually isn't really working for the government anymore, and he's kind of turned his back on all of that, but there's an incident that happens near the beginning of the game that really brings him back in. And initially, Grimm's not too happy about that because Sam is coming to step on her turf again. Splinter Cell Blacklist is out on PlayStation 3, Xbox 360 and PC, and it's out on August the 22nd this year.